It is 1878 Casuals again. This is Sinatra. I got the Maddest of Faces, Casey Gale, Bandito Mike, and the Anonymous Englishman.
I'm petting the dog. Dog keeps
He's
talking
petting the dog. So the dog is also a star of the show.
Whatever you and your dog do, it's your own business.
Yeah. Easy now.
All right. So
he's your friend.
So let's get it started. Some news out of the Webby and O'Neill channel, also on YouTube, that a consortium bid is imminent. So I want to get the boys' thoughts on this. It's interesting that it's not in the major press yet. It seems to be an exclusive out of the Webby and O'Neill channel. So I'm going to go to Bandito to get some more specifics on this one. What are we talking about, Mikey?
Yeah, good point. So Tony O'Neill is the first person source. He is the source. So the consortium has gone to he and Webby, being, you know, decade-long supporters of the club, home and away. If you don't know who Tony O'Neill is, you know, I first learned about him through this book here, The Men in Black, and then he's got Red Army General. So he's, former top boy of one of the biggest firms in United, you know, 80s and 90s. And then he had his, he organized away trips into Europe to see United. Very well connected, you know, within the club, and everyone around town knows, you know, Darren Webb and Bucket, they call it Tony O'Neill. So really interesting that this consortium has gone to the Webby O'Neill channel, and just because of, you know, who they are and the authenticity and respect they have among United supporters, it's gone to them and ask about their take on the buy-in that they want to have. So I guess according to Tony O'Neill, this was happening about 3 months ago, and they've made a £1 billion offer for 26%. So, you know, if there's later on, if there's another 25%, that's 51%, that's controlling portion of the club. So they sat on this until it was made public that the group, the funds have been proven to be there, and now it's in the Glazers court to, you know, progress the talks about selling 26% of the club.
Is there anything to read into them sitting on it for 3 months? It's kind of interesting. When I heard that, I was like, wow, they've been sitting on this a while, and no leaks, no indication from anywhere that this was imminent. And now it sounds like in any day we could hear, you know, more news on it.
So the reason stated is that they wanted to wait until those funds were proven, right? So now that's to the Glazers. The Glazers have authenticity that the funds are there, that the £1 billion is there. So that's kind of what triggered them to make this announcement.
So my question is, is the consortium separate from Sir yes. Jim Layton potentially? Yes. So he's the guy that comes in with the remaining 25% for the controlling stake, or how is that supposed to work?
Well,
yeah. Go ahead.
What I've heard, they're waiting. They're going to try to invite Mr. Ratcliffe to join, but they're totally, there's five people trying to buy the club, apparently. And this is one group, and like, as Bandito said, but they have Ratcliffe is separate from these guys. So I don't think Ratcliffe would want to go for 26% or whatever. I think he wants to get the whole lot. So I don't know. I don't know how it's going to work.
So this consortium, they're all supposed to be United fans, right?
Yeah.
That's, I mean, my thought, if they're holding it up for 3 months, I mean, they've got to get approval as to who's putting the bid in, because, you know, after they just kicked out Abramovich from Chelsea, the British government's not going to just let anyone come in and buy Manchester United or any other Premier League team right now. So they're going to have to get all that cleared up. I'm very interested in the fans getting a say so and a share, though. That's very interesting.
But isn't it 26 to grow to 51% or something like that?
Right.
Yeah.
But so this doesn't really get the Glazers out, though.
Not as a start. But it's an important step where you're starting to leverage power and control away from them. So think about how the Glazers took over, right? They just it's just through acquisition of shares, and they just kept getting shares, kept getting more shares.
But they're not stupid, man. You know, I don't see them giving up 51%.
Right.
So yeah, they mentioned it briefly on that little episode they had done on Webby and O'Neill with Tony and his son Kieran, where he had mentioned, you know, that they didn't really like the idea of there being like several different groups with interest in the club. And so I'm with Face. I'm not liking, you know, there's five or six different people, no matter if they're interested in United or not, have an interest in the club. Where do we see the actual, I mean, besides the Glazers being out, what are the other benefits of it coming in? Is that more money going into, football side of things, you know, besides commercialization, or is this looking to, you know, we're going to give it back to the people. We're going to spend the money to actually give the club back to the people and see the club run the way the supporters want. I'm not sure how that fits all together.
I think it depends on who this consortium is, isn't it? And what their plans are. I think the reason they went to Tony is, quite honestly, they wanted to score points with the fans. You know, Tony's in a top boy. Look at what happened at Wrexham with Ryan. If you watch the show, you know, the fan consortium, they had a big meeting on Zoom. You know, they talked to him. He had, you know, XYZ amount of questions there to answer and prove this and prove that. And then the fans, you know, voted on whether, you know, Ryan Reynolds and his boy was going to buy Wrexham. So I would imagine that they're going for the heart and soul. They see what damage the fans are doing to the Glazer family, and they don't want any of that. They want them on their side, right? Mm-hmm. So yeah, right. That so would be my guess.
We don't know. We don't know what their future plans are. I think O'Neill did say, you know, as a fan speaking for himself and the fans that he's talked to, is preferably, you know, you want one person who's got deep pockets to do the things that United need to do to the training grounds, to Old Trafford, and for the squad. But, you know, that's ideal, right? But, you know, I do like the fact that they are coming to, you know, a fan channel, but, you know, Webby and O'Neill are much more than just, you know, YouTubers, right?
Yeah, so, they're connected deep, right? They're into hotel football, they're into other things.
Yeah, they're highly respected, top boys.
But they're doing whatever they got to do, right? I mean, it's like, you know, it's like your first date, isn't it? Trying to get to second base. You do whatever you got to do, say whatever you got to say. I mean, I hope, you know, that it's all roses, but, you know, you just don't know, do you? I mean, these guys can be saying anything they want to say.
If you think back to a couple of weeks ago, when Ratcliffe was talking to a director of football and transfer guru, right, Campos, to bring in. And this is the same thing he said, you know, 20-25% to start with, because that's kind of what came out of the Glazers side, right? That they were willing. Look, the financials came out, the quarterly reports, they've lost 100-something million pounds. They've added an additional almost 90 million pounds to the debt. So they need capital. And the only way they can do that is to start selling parts of the club. So the way they've been trying to get Champions League, spend big, get Champions League, and, you know, it's not working anymore for him. So
it's a write-off.
Hopefully, this is the door out for them.
So it's finally looking like financially it makes sense for them to sell off compared to before, where we were just the permanent ATM. It's apparent that that's not sustainable for them anymore.
Yeah, but I don't understand business. But, you know, it seems to me that these big, you know, billionaires and trillionaires, they make more money by writing money off. When they lose money, they make more money. You know, it's ridiculous. I mean, I see these guys, I hate to say it, but I see them just trying to get a cash influx, you know, so they can get more credit, you know, write off the money they've lost. I mean, and I agree with you that you don't want to have 5, 6, 7, you know, guys in a consortium, but how many people can afford to buy a club like Manchester United and will be allowed to? Don't forget, the government still has to approve all this. They're still going to approve it.
It's not going to be quick like the Chelsea one.
Right. You're not going to get, it's not going to be a Saudi group coming in. They won't let them do that anymore. It won't be Russians. So, you know, I mean, you know, apart from Casey, you know, on a good day, who can afford it, mate?
Yeah.
Okay. Sweet. Awesome on the video, mate, on the views. Lovely job.
So, to what Bandito was saying, and I, like I was saying, I tend to agree, you know, as a United supporter, it would be nice and an ideal situation to have one guy with the deep pockets and that clearly cares about the club. So in theory, Mr. Ratcliffe, Sir Ratcliffe seemed like the ideal candidate for that. So now that we have the sort of separate consortium thing coming in, and like you said, this could be the beginnings of, you know, small chunks to carve away at a time. How are we feeling about the consortium news? Like, how are we feeling in our guts about it? Because we've had a lot of, you know, false hopes, false dawns with getting the Glazers out. How are we feeling in our guts right now? Let's start with Madface. How are we feeling in our gut?
I really don't know what to feel because I don't know enough about information about it. I just know that I'm just concerned that, I just want the Glazers out as soon as possible. But I don't know enough information. We don't know the time frame these people are working with. So I really don't know what to feel. That's how I'm on. I mean, it seems like Mr. Ratcliffe is just everybody's coming up with ideas and they want to bring him along. He seems like the one everyone needs. What does he feel? I mean, he might be like, why is everybody using me as their little pawn? Because he could buy the team by himself.
Exactly.
He could throw $6 bill at him.
What are you feeling, Bandito? What's in your gut?
I agree with Face in a lot of sense that it's a big mystery, and we're, you know, we want to feel that it's going to be owners that are going to be, you know, stewardship to the club and to the fans. I will say I am glad it's not oil money. You know, we've slate, you know, City and
no terrorism money.
I didn't say that.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
PSG and City, the sugar daddy, and even, you know, Chelsea for years. So, you know, we don't want that for our club. But I am hopeful that this is, you know, this is 26% possibly. That's a serious chunk of and that's going to be, you know, input in running the club at that level, right? So they're going to have board members, and it's not going to be the, you know, the A shares and B shares. Are you guys familiar with how the Glazers do that? Their shares, their votes are like 10 times more.
Yeah, it's like every Glazer vote counts as double compared to another board member or whatever, right? That's how it's supposed to work.
It's a step, and you know, I'm hopeful that that's, you know, this is the, you know, the beginning of the end and the Glazers. Now, I know it's not going to happen overnight, but, you know, it's a start.
And then finally, the thoughts of our Englishman and parts unknown.
Yeah, well, look, so we know this consortium is not Sir Jim, right? I agree that it would be great to have one guy, especially a Manchester United fan, buying. But, yeah, I don't care if it's 100 million, billions. No one person, especially a businessman that successful, is going to take that on nut on itself. It's just not going to.
Yeah.
You see, I mean, even though you're not going to really lose money owning Manchester United, no businessman, don't forget, we're not talking about just a fan. It's business, right? And that's the way they're going to look at it. And it's cold, it's precise, it's, you know, it's cut up into sections. So one guy is just not going to do that. Again, if we don't know who the consortium is, you can't really say. I guarantee you that no more Saudi money will buy any more clubs in England. It just won't happen. And again, you've got to get through the British government right now with the Queen just passing, etc. There'd be so many more things going on. that it's going to be much harder to buy a football club. So, so Jim, I think he's just going to end up being the front man. Hopefully these other guys are English and they're Manchester United fans and the fans get the fair shake that they promised. That's all I can hope for, you know?
So in conclusion, we're hopeful, but we don't have all the facts. Not all the facts are in yet. And so I guess we're going to hold off on judgment until we get more. And hopefully Tony and O'Neill or somebody will be quick with us next week with some more information.